This new editing tool gives you trimming control in a fun new way using the search style right here. Well, today I'm going to show you everything you need to know about trimming with the Speed Editor in DaVinci Resolve. Let's dive in. So before we get into looking at these trim buttons, which are on this left, lower left side of the Speed Editor, I want to point your direction to the Cam 1, Cam 2, Cam 3 buttons. These aren't just used for sync bend, they are also used for your track selection. So if I push one, I've already done it here, it's highlighted on track one. If I push two, it jumps me up to two. So, and if I push three, I actually have a track, a video on track three way over here at the beginning. So it's a quick way to navigate between each level on the timeline, one, two, and three. One more setup tip I want to give you real quick in the cut page here is to make sure you can see your waveforms large down on this big zoomed in timeline. And the way you do that is this button right over here under audio trim, click this guy right here. And now when we go in and we learn about trim in and trim out, they just blow up huge and you can see them really good. If that's not enabled and it's sort of grayed out, this is what you get. It's just the waveforms, which is not nearly as useful. I generally always just leave this audio trim button selected, and this lets me see the audio waveforms while I'm trimming nice and big. So DaVinci Resolve has three different places to do trims in the cut page. There's the viewer, they call that the AB trimmer. There's the upper timeline and the lower timeline. All of those you can trim in. But for our purposes today, we're going to be focusing on the lower timeline. It gives us the most detail to use with the speed editor. There's two primary ways to make a timeline shorter or longer when you're in the cut page. The first one, and the one that's most simple, is if you use the split button, which is right here, tap that once, and what that does is it puts a cut, and then you can use ripple delete, which is right here. So that has just made our timeline shorter, as we see. I'm gonna undo that with double tap escape, because I wanna talk to you about trim in and trim out. These functions are basically doing the same thing. They're making a timeline shorter or longer, but they're doing it in a much more refined way using the search style. So the way they work is really actually pretty simple. So let's say we want this shot to end as the roller coaster comes down right there. I am going to use trim out, hold it down, and then as I move the search style to the left here, I'm gonna keep pulling it back, and I can see up there in the upper right viewer that it has just now gone out of frame. So that's where I want that. And then if I wanna go to the beginning of the clip, and there's a bunch of excess right there as well, I'll go to trim in on the speed editor. I'm holding it down. And as I rotate the search dial, it has come into frame right around, maybe we'll bring it right there. So if we go back to the beginning of the timeline, push stop play on the speed editor, we can see we've now trimmed that clip to just the portion that we want real easily with trim in, trim out. So the thing to remember is ripple trim in, ripple trim out. Those are the trim modes that are gonna make your video shorter or longer. Next to trim in, trim out, we have roll. If you hold down roll, it grabs the nearest edit point. You move left and right with the search dial. And this is like the quid pro quo of trimming. So it's taking and giving at the same time. So in this instance, if I hold this down and I go to the left, it's taking away from the A side, the left side clip, and it's giving the same amount to the right side at the same time. So if I move to the right, it's doing the exact opposite. This is helpful if you want to time this out to like beats of music or something. So this little montage right here is sort of timed out to music, and it works pretty good. So you can see how that works, pretty slick. Another great use of the roll button here that's on the speed editor is to do a J cut or L cut, but you can't do it in the cut page. So that's one little tip. If you hit shift 4, that'll take you to the edit page, and you turn linked selection off, which is this guy right here, you're able to hit roll, and then you can move the video track independent of the audio tracks beneath it to get that real smooth, indivisible cut of a J cut or an L cut. Real quick, I wanna say welcome if you're new here. My name is Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips, where I help you create videos that make a difference and stand out. If that's something you're into, please click subscribe right now so you don't miss out on my tip next week. Now let's jump back into the computer. We're gonna learn all about my favorite trimming mode called slip. So slip is my favorite type of edit mode for sure, or trim mode. It's these buttons here, slip source and slip destination. For some reason, DaVinci decided they needed two buttons for slip, where every other editing system I've ever worked, it's just wherever your playhead is parked over, that would slip it. The cut page makes things a little different here in Resolve. It's based off of that smart indicator. So we see that triangle there on the left of my playhead. That is determining what our source and our destination is. So if you hold these down, hold source down, it's gonna do everything left of that playhead, and then destination is everything right of it. But what slip is gonna do, it's gonna change the inner guts of this shot. So let's take a look at what the shot is to begin with. The roller coaster comes down, but it doesn't come down until halfway through the shot. And what slip does is it lets you keep the length of the timeline the exact same throughout, but it changes the inner guts. So from here to here is gonna stay the same, but the inside of that clip container is gonna change. So for me to make the change on here, because I've got the smart indicator to the left, I'm gonna choose slip destination on the speed editor. It's gonna highlight the clip I wanna change. And now while it's holding down, we can move the search dial. And we'll see in that upper right section in our viewer, we'll see the upper left is the first frame of the clip. The upper right is the last frame of that clip. And then the bottom two are telling me what frames look like on the left of the clip and on the right of the clip. So the incoming shot and the outcoming shot. So what I'm going to try to do is time this out so the roller coaster is dropping down and going out of frame right as we get to this clip. So we can see as I move this here, in the upper right, our roller coaster is just starting to drop down. And on the other outcoming side, it has just coming out. So right around there, it's like it's gonna fill this container. It's gonna fill these guts with the shot going through the frame. So I'll release the slip destination button. I'll come back here and play it. And we see that entire shot is filled up now with the roller coaster moving through the frame. So we've just sort of changed the guts. And that's the essence of what slip does. It's a super powerful, super useful thing for refining edits after you've sort of locked in your timing and your music.
The thing to remember about a slip edit is just like your mama told you when you were little. It's what's on the inside edit that counts, right?
The last type of trim I want to show you today is slide. Slide is right underneath the roll button. It's there for a reason because it's basically doing two different rolls at the same time on both sides of the clip. The way it works is you double tap, hold it, and then move the search dial. So this is a little bit different than just a hold and search dial. It's a double tap hold to get to that secondary function. So double tap hold selects that clip that we had just slid in the previous section. And we'll move this to the left here so that we are taking up a little bit of that clip on the left. And we can see in the lower left of the viewer monitor, we're seeing the last frame of it. And I want to roll this till the roller coaster goes right out of frame, okay? Right there seems pretty good. We release it and it basically sticks it there. So we can go back and preview it, push the play button, and we've moved that clip left in the timeline without changing the length of the overall timeline. That's the benefit of slide, is it keeps the length, it just moves the clips left and right on the timeline. So that's slide in a nutshell. It's a double tap, you hold it, go left and right, and it is taking up and giving to the clips left and right of it. And so this is great if you wanna sync something up to music, maybe a sound effect, a sound bite, but you don't wanna change the overall length of your video. Slide is what you wanna be using.
Now you're officially a master of all things trimming with the DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in learning more about the Speed Editor, I actually have a playlist. It'll be popping up somewhere right around here right now. And I've got all kinds of great things to learn about DaVinci Resolve with the Speed Editor. If you want to learn multicam and just how it works differently in a cut page and edit page, love for you to check it out. And I'll see you over in those videos.